WM Ministries, where we believe in the one new man, Jew and Gentile, the one new man being revealed in Yeshua. Hallelujah. Glory to God. I want to thank y'all for coming out today. I want to thank the people streaming. Share. My God. Post, repost. You can evangelize right from your phone. Just repost the message. Send it to random people. Send it out. Evangelize. Steal the word. Ah, my God. Good to see you, DJ. Good to see both of the DJs up in the house. I feel covered now. Glory to God. Amen. Hallelujah. Ah, God, I would never forsake the assembling themselves together. As I told y'all Friday, my faith is in God. My faith ain't in the science. Man. Man, glory to God. I'm moving, teacher. I'm moving. I'm getting there. Doing what I'm designed to do. Oh my God. Man. I can feel God. He is. I can feel His presence, man. Amen. 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 And He is worthy, Cinder Rollins. He is worthy. He is worthy. You go ahead. We understand. Glory to God. We understand. Woo! Hallelujah. 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 Just like we understand when one of us falls. I understand. Man, I understand. I understand. See, I need y'all to do that. When you see your brother, sister fall, and you should say, I understand, man. See, it's not saying you condone it. It's not saying you agree, but you, as a believer, you can look at them and say, I understand. I understand the state that you're in. I understand your mindset. I understand the familiar spirits on your family. I understand the curse that you've been speaking. I understand that. Hallelujah. See, and if you do that, you'll have, listen, mercy. You look at people strange when they fall. You look at people strange, you hear the testimony of the whites. It just shows you how disconnected we are with one another. That you haven't went into your secret place. All seems right with the marriage, but what's really going on? Father, in the name of Jesus, show me what my brother, my sister, listen, is being opposed with right now. Show me. Let me go ahead of them. See, we don't do that. Show me the warfare that is around their family. Let me see so I can pray effectively. We don't do that. We talk about how could you? I knew it wouldn't deliver. So after a testimony like that, everyone should have bent on their knees and say, protection now that he's exposed. himself fully to you. It don't just end then. Then you have to war over the testimony. Amen. You should know he gonna come at him hard now. Listen, he could come through at him through one of you. Okay. Hallelujah. We must begin to comprehend the spiritual realm. We must begin to understand how we are to operate in the spirit. Your battle is in the spirit realm. It's not in the natural. So how are we going to win? How are we going to fight if we don't know the realm that we're in? How are you going to swim if you're in the water and you don't know how to swim? You're going to drown. Okay. Hallelujah. One of the first things that a human being is exposed to is this, a relationship. When that child is birthed into this world, the first thing that is formed is a relationship. It is a relationship. Everything is about relationship. Because everything relates. See, what's wrong with a lot of us is we had poor relationships. Somebody was mean or cruel to you because of their poor relationship with whoever. You are damaged because of a relationship. Oh my God. I really want to, you know me, I always had a message within a message. I mean, I want to talk about, you know, non-growth, a mindset. But, however, the Lord said we got to have a little intervention today. He must intervene. And I want to talk just a little bit. If I talk about marriage, guess what I'm talking about? Amen. Relationship. God deals with everything like with us with a marriage. Because it's about a relationship. How many of you want to find out some things about yourself? Oh my God. Oh. WM Ministry loves relationships. I mean, I know some of y'all not married. I mean, I ask you to raise your hand, but some of y'all want to get married, right? Some of y'all want to get married. If that's you, say yeah. Yeah. Right. Now, some of y'all lying in here. Ain't said nothing. Don't let your flesh speak for you. All right. All right. Okay, all right. Can I just give you a little shortcut? Can I throw a key out there to you? All right. Okay. All right, you got it. You got it, minister. This will help a lot of men and women who want to get married. Y'all got to pray the prayer right, though. Okay? You got to pray the prayer right. Now, you can, as y'all learned with the Weiss, they were, I need a few more keys on that one. Go ahead, take your drink, but I need a few more keys, man. Roll with me. See, the beautiful thing, there you go. All right. The beautiful thing is that the Weiss gave y'all a key, too. Now, minister said, if I'm not the husband, send the right husband to her. See, within the marriage, you can be remarried. Ain't got to be no new man, new woman. All right. You didn't see it. Went right past you. They gave you all the keys. All right. What we need to pray and help some of y'all with a lot of work that you be putting in. You need to know how to pray this. Now, when you go to God, you ain't got to come to me, Pastor, pray for my husband. No. No, then if it's the wrong person, then you're going to blame me. That's what we're not going to do. Now, once you got them, I'll tell you what to do. Anyway, all right. You need to pray like this. Lord, bring me a husband or a wife that will love and honor you. Amen. No, you missed. Y'all hope y'all got that key right there. Bring me a man or husband or wife that will love you and honor you. Amen. Some of y'all didn't pray it right. Because if he love and honor you, he's no question that he will love me. No question. No question. None. Non-existent. Oh, my God. Some of us just need to get remarried. All right. All right. Yeah, I'll say it again. That's exactly what you prayed. That would love God and love her children. And then she was patient. 50,000 counterfeits come first. Love is patient. That's right. Love is patient. Amen. Woo! Okay. How much time y'all gonna give me today? I need y'all to give me like 10 pages worth today. Okay, I'm moving fast. All right. Lord, bring me a husband or wife. You say it. You fill in the blank. That will love and honor you. Amen. You ain't got to worry about it. He won't pray. He don't like to come to church. And he's not a tither. You ain't got to worry about all that. That will love and honor God. That's how you do it, huh? Amen. All right. I just want to help some people today. Can I help? That's my job. All right. All right. All right. I'm coming. I got something for the men and the women. And this is one thing. If I could just get this from the men. And I'm going to break it down, but I'm going to start off right here. With saying, if men have to understand. Men have to understand. What we don't is we don't understand the helper. I love that right there. We don't understand the helper. This is a big issue. Teacher, stop. You're in my stuff right here. I'm going in here. All right. Can we get started just to get y'all ready? All right. Frida, you ready? Okay. All right. I'm ready back there. I see they got the daughters. It's so beautiful. There's so much I see. The beauty of God and his people, man. Okay, let me start by saying this. A man is not another woman. And a woman is not another man. I'm going to try to. This is very important. Okay? Y'all see I'm calm. On Sundays, it's just something different anointing. Tuesday and Friday, I'm at it. I'm just, my mouth going too fast and spitting all over the thing. Passionate. Thank y'all. The concept of love from the perspective of a man is far different from the concept of what love is for a woman. I'm going to help today if you won't help. Okay. All right. What I want us to understand is that today I'm talking in how you were designed to function. I'm going to the template. Okay? The how. This will bring understanding to both parties. That's the issue. We don't know. No, we don't. Okay. Because our relationship outside of the home unit would be different how we fellowship with each other. Overall, wide spectrum over the body of Christ. So much division. Because our homes are divided. If our homes are divided, then our church is divided. Then the body of Christ is divided because you bring division into. Okay. I'm trying to. Okay. The Bible says that when God brought man into being, the Bible says that when God brought man into being, all that man focused was, watch this, was his purpose and destiny. Okay? Honor and authority. Man was conscious, watch this, of his place. Okay? In the earth. And his relationship, watch this, with his creator. And with everything God had given him. He was in perfect relationship. He was in the right place. He was focused on the right things. Okay, my God. Everything, every time you talk of love from a man perspective, and we're going to go there first, okay? And help some of y'all ladies. Amen. Every time we talk about love from a man's, listen to me, a man's perspective, it means two things. Every time we talk about love from a man's perspective, it means two things. It means honor and respect. Now I'm coming. I'm talking about how God designed us. I ain't even brought in the love of God like that and all this. I'm not talking about that. I'm talking about how he designed us. How he made us. Okay? Love to a man, from his perspective, women, is honor and respect. Okay. Oh, it's got, yeah. I'm going to say it. It takes three times at the charm, I guess. So, all right. All right. from a male's perspective and man's perspective, not a boy. It's a difference. A man's perspective is love. His perspective of love, his perspective of love, how he's designed, is honor and respect. Cindy, you got two beautiful grandkids right here, right? So what's in Adonis, what's built into his design? Nothing else. It's honor and respect. One day he's going to be a husband. That's what's in him. That's his concept. That's how he's designed. Okay? All right. No matter how you claim or how much you claim that you love the man, if that concept of love does not translate to genuine honor and respect, you have not loved that man, watch this, in the definition of how God made him. Go ahead, you can throw some. All right, see there? There you go. Go and start it again. You have not because you receive not. All right, I'm going to do this. That's what we're supposed to do. Yeah. Amen. Amen. Watch this. Y'all want me to say that again? No matter much, no matter how calm or how you think you're loving that man, if that concept does not translate as genuine honor and respect, you have not loved that man by his definition of how God, watch this, made him. Look at all the people just looking all around. Look quiet on the left side over here. What's going on? I ain't no shouts or nothing. Okay, all right. I'm going to slay. I mean, are y'all with me? All right, you want to see yourself. We're going to see yourself today. All right, here we go. All right. Women need to understand this, right? Because men have killed because of these two things. This is deep right here, y'all. I need the women to understand that. Women, say honor and respect.
Honor and respect.
All right. All right. Y'all are funny. All right. If the concept, listen to that real closely, does not translate as genuine, honor and respect, that's the key word. You have not loved him by his definition of how God made him. Okay. That's right. Women need to understand this because men have killed because of these two things, honor and respect. Men have killed simply because someone called them out of their name. Have killed them. Have killed. Honor. Listen, it doesn't matter. Another man can do the same thing, honor and disrespect. Because that's how he's designed. That's his definition. God built that in him. So you got to be careful how you disrespect a little boy growing up. Glory to God. Hallelujah. See, this won't go viral, you know. I get up there and do some crazy stuff. It'll go viral. But this right here won't go. Y'all need to share this with people. Okay. All right. There you go. Like, share, and post. Do I need to remind y'all of my favorite character, Vashti? Vashti. Vashti. She did not honor or respect the man, and she lost her position. There's a reason she ended up in the Word, ladies. The book of Esther. Might want to go check it out. All right. Okay, here we go. Y'all feeling all right? Okay. All right. Okay. Watch this, ladies. Watch this. Ladies, it's not his ego. It's not his ego. It's his configuration. By, watch this. By design. It's how he was configured. By design. Because he wants respect and honor. That's not an ego.
You are helping a very deep.
All right. All right. Break every chain. All right, here we go. Did I hear that sound? All right. Sound of chains falling. All right. Ladies, it's not his ego. It's how he was configured. It's his configuration by design. It's his template. You will never get the best of a man if you don't understand what love means from his perspective. To him. You will never get the best of that man. You will never get the best of that man if you don't understand his perspective of love. How he was configured and designed. Oh. Amen. You want you? Woo! Now, hold on, y'all. Let me help you. Now, I'm talking about how he's designed. Now, there's other things that have happened to the man, how he is like he is. And how she is like she is. There's. I'm talking about the original. That's right. I ain't talking about his environment and how he got to where he is at this moment. I'm talking about the original design, the original configuration of God's design for the man and the woman. That's what I'm talking about. All right, because some of you are putting together things. Okay, wait a minute. Just listen right now. Don't put no pieces together yet. Okay? Don't put no pieces together yet. Amen. I felt that, Yolanda. Here we go. Watch this. It's not his ego, I said, right? Okay. If you want the best out of a man, you have to understand what love means from his perspective of a man, right? Wow. Remember, y'all, I'm talking about our makeup, okay? I'm not talking about God's love yet, okay? So, women. What does it mean to love a man? All right. Q was right out. She was out the block on that one. Amen. All right. I don't think y'all said that with feeling women. Y'all didn't say that. Hold on. Y'all didn't say that how you was designed. And I'm going to get to you in a second. No, you didn't say that how you were designed. You didn't say that within that. So what does it mean to love a man from his perspective? That should have been like that from the beginning. If y'all were with me, if you were with me. I'm trying to help you. Okay. Okay. All right. Oh, my time is flying by. Oh. So what does it mean to honor? So what does it mean to honor him? It means to hold in high esteem. Go ahead, fall out. It's nice and clean. No COVID-19 on the floor. We good. Clean. Y'all can fall out here. All right, here we go. All right. Y'all streaming, y'all listening? All right. Type me in, you listening. Let me see. All right. So what does it mean to honor a man? It means to hold him in high esteem. She said, give an example. You got your teacher right there. How? How do you esteem him highly? I would get Right. I mean, I could give you one. I mean, but it's almost like the women, you need to answer that. Because it's your heart. It's your heart. That's the how-to. It's your relationship with him. Yeah? Okay. All right. But I've been in practice all week with this whole teaching, this in my own relationship. Amen. As we explore this, you will know the reason. Watch this. Why some relationships will never work. And why some homes will never come together. It doesn't matter what kind of message is being preached to you. It doesn't matter what kind of teaching that you're sitting under. It's not just about Satan and demons. We have to get our fundamentals. We have to get the fundamental things straight first. How we are designed and how we are to function. This is the fundamental thing. So I ain't even bringing in Satan and the demons yet. Can't bring them in yet. I'm talking about the very fundamental things. You got to get that straight first. I'm going to help us with relationships. And oh, my God. So when you respect the man, women, I need to make sure that women in the back room with the kids hear this too. All right? So when you respect the man, you respect his assignment. You respect his call. You respect his purpose. Ain't nobody say that again, Pastor. Why ain't nobody say that again? I ain't hear the women say, Pastor, say that again. All right, man, say that. Anybody say that online? Say that again. All right, all right. All right. All right. I came to worship. All right, here we go. This is worship for me. Amen. Listen to this. Okay. So when you respect the man, y'all said y'all, when you respect him, you respect his assignment. You respect his call. And you respect his purpose. Listen, this is what circumference. This is the circumference of what, watch this, love means to a man. Respect and honor. Y'all follow me? Yeah. All right. This is very important, women. Okay? Women, never forget this. Say, I'm going to never forget this. All right. Watch this. What I'm about to say. Women, your primary ministry or your fixed ministry is that God has put inside every woman is to be a help meet for the man. I know y'all heard this. I need y'all to hear this. Your primary, listen, I know you've been called to the nations and to evangelize. You've been called to teach and preach. But your primary ministry, your fixed ministry, is to be a help to the man of God. That's what God put inside of you. With your powerful self. That's what he put inside of you. Y'all follow me? All right. See, we got folks stepping outside of their ministry. Powerful prophetess. But your primary ministry, your fixed ministry, is to be a help. A helpmeet for a man. Watch this. This is God's design and template for you.
Amen.
Take ownership of that.
Amen.
Be a good steward over that. Your primary function. You can't blame him. All right. It is okay. All right, man. All right. All right. Everything all right over there? All right. Praise God. All right. All right. Here we go. I ain't gonna say it. All right. All right. Watch this. This was the first mention of a woman in the Bible. This is the first mention of a woman. That she be a help to the man for his assignment. First mention is that she be a help. Okay, a helper. All right. All right. I just need us to get that. Watch this. This would end a lot of issues in our marriages. If men truly understood that part. That would end a lot of problems in our marriages. If they understood that she is your helper. Meaning you need help. DJs, y'all going to need a help one day. One day, you're going to need a helper. She, it could be a little girlfriend first, but this, if you're trained right, it's going to be a helper. All right? Don't, not right now. Put that to the side. Work on you. All right. Praise God. Don't put the cart before the horse. All right. Let's do this. Let's not do that. I'm going to say, I think I need to say that one more time. Which section do I need to say that at? All right. This will help a lot of marriages. If the man truly understood that, she is there to help. Now, her delivery might not be to your liking. But her primary function is to help you. See, that's the real issue, is the delivery. There you go. Amen. Amen. That's why we're teaching this right now. That's what we're doing right now. We're fine-tuning. Now listen to this. Y'all ready? Stay focused. Look up here. All right. Let's stay focused. That sound good, didn't it? Y'all want to hear that? Okay, y'all say, no, go move on, Pastor. This will end a lot of marriage if the man truly understood. Amen, y'all got it. If you truly understood, she's there to help. And I know it's the way she said it to me. But she was right. Okay. It's sad to say, but most men, not all men, still struggle with God's assignment for their lives. Not all, some. Most. A great majority. Right. Still struggle with their assignment for their life. Okay, y'all found me. Y'all got me. Okay. Oh, this is going to help Whitney. You're going to be ready, ain't you?
Yes,
I know that's right. Woo! Glory to God. Amen. The Bible says, it is not good for man or the man that I have created and given an assignment to be alone. I will create you a helper, a suitable. Boy, I could have went somewhere with that one. I wish I could get my daughters to see the power in that, of you being a helper, a suitable. But the word, and when we hear that, it has twisted. I'm going to get to that. I'm going to help us with that too. Why some of the women feel the way they feel about being a helper. And I told you what submission is. Submission is what? Taking one powers and putting it under another. That's what submission is. That means you have great power to bring it, watch it, under the control of another. That's why men have a great problem with submission to another man. Because they can't. But a woman. I'm talking about how God created you, T. I'm talking about how God designed you. Is to take all of that anointing and power and submit it under control. Submission. Suitable means right or appropriate for a particular person. That's why everybody can't be your husband. Because you're not a suitable just for anyone. Some of them have learned that by trial and error.
You right.
All right. I'm looking for her. No, you're looking, love. You're looking for a wife. No, I'm looking for a suitable. Who is designed appropriate for a particular person. Listen, for a particular person, purpose, or situation. My God, suitable. Oh, Jesus. Watch it. That's God's design. Let me see here. Okay. I was hoping I was almost finished. And the Bible says this. It says that her desire shall be to her husband. Her desire should be to her husband. I'm saying we just don't know how to function. Her thoughts, her passion, her hunger. That's desire. We're talking about desire. You know how you desire that cheesecake? Desire. She'll be to her husband. So when you love that man, you respect him. You honor him. Sarah called Abraham Lord. Listen, it's not a sign of worship. The word Lord in that context means I esteem. I esteem you. In the context there, Lord means that. Listen, that is a beautiful position that God has given a man and a woman. Oh, my goodness. Just know, you need to know this, that there is a satanic movement to try to awaken the woman. That, listen, this is what it is. Watch this. That she can be better than the man. Not equal. Better. This is a satanic movement that's happening. Not that she's equal, that she's better. Than the man. You see it in the movies. You see it in the commercials, in the media. Girl, all that. You see it. Now that right there is satanic in its nature. You see it in churches. Look at that. You see it in the church. Now that is a satanic spirit that's in the church. That's going, watch this, against the word of God. It's going against how you were designed. How you were designed to function. You see it in our government. Total disrespect and honor. You have the president and you have the speaker of the house. What do you see from Ms. Pelosi? What do you see? You see total dishonor. That's a spirit. I don't want to talk about this though. The very foundation of her creation, her design. That's what you see going against the woman in the spirit realm. Her design. This movement is being orchestrated now by demons. Y'all want to eat this. That are bringing the woman into straight, watch this teacher, rebellion. All the stuff in the commercials, the government, all the stuff you see promulgating, listen, it's rebellion. Dishonor. Nah. It's designed to bring her against her design, against her designer. Against how God created her, how to function. It brings her in straight rebellion against her husband in her home. What I saw played out, I just see what's going on in home. There's no way that you are submitted to him and not him. Straight rebellion. You going against your very design. So who's running the BLM? Who's running that? All right. Designed to bring you into straight rebellion. It's a spirit. You see it in every nation. Now you see it in every nation. It's a spirit of rebellion. Do we really want to pull back the veneer and see what's really happening? Amen. I feel good. I got a connection with you now. You said something. All right. Amen. I want to hear that. I connect with them. You know? Listen to this. Your respect for a man when you get married is not just that the function and his ability to provide alone. Okay? Your respect for the man when you get married is not that in the function of his ability. You should not just put all your function and ability for him to provide alone. While that is very true, though. But if that is all you desire, you are in violation of scripture. So you marry men just to take care of you and pay your bills. You are in strict violation of the scripture. Even though that is his responsibility too. But if that's your desire, and that alone. I asked my wife, I said, if I can't do all the things that I'm doing for you now, will you still love me? I said that I ain't even had the Holy Ghost. Yet I was called. Okay, all right. It had not yet manifested. But I was called before the foundation. but it had not yet been a reality to me. I wasn't living it. Amen? All right. You're in violation of the scripture because agape love is unconditional love. It's a position that God has put you in. My goodness. Now I want to talk about the woman. Y'all think I can finish this? Wow. Okay. So I'm going to need the men to listen carefully. All right. I like that. I'm going to need the men to listen carefully. Young men too. Help y'all. Oh. Ketabo say. All right. Here we go. Amen. Love does not mean purpose for a woman. Love does not mean purpose to a woman. Okay. Oh, just follow me. Okay, good. I like that. Love does not mean purpose for the woman. Love for the woman has nothing to do with destiny. And the teacher is like, where is you going with this? All right, watch. I'm again talking about how she's designed. Y'all bringing in the kingdom and everything. Yeah, I'm talking about the design first. Right, before the fall. Okay? All right. Family. Say family. All right. I can fall out this chair right now, y'all. Okay. I mean, were you going to give me a piece, too? I mean, okay, here we go. All right. Okay. Here we go, y'all. Let's do this. Don't this feel like old times? Yeah. Woo! All right, here we go. All right, control yourselves. All right, here we go. All right. All right. For the woman, it has nothing to do with destiny. And again, I said, I'm talking about her design, how she functions. That's the key word, how she functions. Say function.
Function.
All right. I want to help us with something. That's the key word. Okay, yeah. Now, women, don't get offended. Okay. Okay. I put the disclaimer out first. Amen. I like that. God, dog. Okay, well, go ahead. I'm going to move on ahead then. The fragile nature of a woman and her emotional configuration. I've been studying my wife, y'all. I don't know about it. I've been studying my wife. I put some things out and see what the response. I'm studying her. But you got to be skilled in that. I'm going to help you with that. Okay. You got to be skilled in that. See, first of all, whatever I deal with her is genuine. Even my studying her is genuine in my heart. Okay. I ain't trying to entrap her. See, I told you. That's it. Nah. That's dumb. That's games. And we ain't playing no games. The fragile nature of a woman and her emotional configuration, watch this, was designed on purpose. God, you are everything. You are so known. It was designed on purpose. Fragile means this: easily broken or damaged. And you know, when the Bible said that she was made, but she was the weaker of them. Not love. See, women read that, and sometimes they take that. I'm strong. Yes, I. Watch the spirit. Because you don't have understanding right now. And I'm going to bring you into understanding. Fragile means easily. Easily broken or damaged. Meaning that she is to be handled with precision care. See, we're missing the... I gave y'all the scenario with the egg in the mouth. Y'all men looking up at me? Make eye contact with all the men. Okay. All right. Fragile means that she is easily broken and damaged. Meaning she should be handled with great precision and care. And God put that care within man. See how many of y'all done went against your design? When it pertains to you? Now remember, she's a helper. Meaning that she is as strong or if not stronger than me. Other than that, she wouldn't be a helper. She has to be. She has to be. I'm going to need some of these men to stop going against the design. She's there to help you. She's there to help you. You're not supposed to be helpless. Fragile means that she needs to be handled with precision care, and God put that care in man. The places I put her in has to be well calculated with extreme foresight and care. The things, the places that I place her in. Y'all see what I'm saying? So you keep forgetting she's fragile. So she's easily damaged. And God entrusted man with that care. I know you'd be like, where are some of the men that need to hear this? I hear your spirit. I hear your spirit. I hear your spirit. That's right. Because love is patient and kind. Amen. My goodness, I heard you. Woo! She said, contact. Men, you have to be careful where you place her. The places that you place her have to be well calculated. With foresight. She shouldn't be taking you. You shouldn't be taking to all your woes. You know, you're in a blended family, and she dealing with the spouse, the other spouse, and not you. Don't move her out the way. And you handle that. It's your child. Why is she even in? Okay. That's for some people. Oh, my God. Online, y'all missing it. You got to be here. You got to be here. Y'all gonna let me finish it? I'm gonna finish it. I promise you, I'm gonna finish it. I almost finished, y'all. I'm gonna finish it today. Right. Well, I'm not gonna finish. I'm gonna end it today, but I'll move on to, we'll get some more in there. All right. Okay, here we go. He talking about he didn't give us one scripture. I gave you plenty of scripture. All right. All right. Amen. Now watch this. The places that I put her has to be calculated with extreme foresight and care. Watch this. Because she's valued. She's of great value. See, this is why. See, you can't be offended when women you hear that you're fragile. See, you're missing it. You're missing it. It's been twisted the wrong way. No. See, we get that twisted, you know, I'm fragile. No, you get that. No, that's mouthy. You run your mouth. Just shh, shh. Ain't nobody sewing to that. Okay. Remember, you're fragile. Shh. Shh. All right, here we go. She's valued. She's vulnerable. And men, she's easily broken. She shouldn't be hard or hardened. Two men can't run a household. Mm-mm. That mean that you got to step up, men, in the right position. Whatever my wife say. Yeah, after what I said. See, and then a lot of us ain't in that area of trust yet in our relationship to allow her to go ahead and speak for us. We're not there yet. All right. And I'm going to leave no doors open. There's a natural part, but there's a spiritual part too. And I prefer to stay with the spiritual part. But since some of you are natural, you got to go there. All right. No. Okay. He didn't design you to be hard and hardened. Oh, I got something. Y'all just hold on. Now, remember again, I got to bring you back. I'm talking about the original design. I'm not talking about where you at right now because of whatever elements and whatever happened to you. Go with me to the original first, all right? Okay. I'm going to make sure that's my learning outcome. And when we're teaching to you today, they know I'm talking about the original. Women, God designed this side of you to be able. I want to say this. You're designed to be compliant with the man. See, we simply don't know how each other function. We married, but we don't know how each other function. That's the issue with a lot of marriages. But we don't know how we are to function in our perspective. Listen, you know, beings. How we were designed. Compliant. The woman being hard as a rock is not a gift. It's not a gift to the husband. Why I feel like we got to challenge each other. What is that? Oh, we going toe to toe. We going toe to toe. What is that? One is not a marriage. Okay. All right. That woman being hard as a rock is not a gift to the man or to the husband. Well, watch this. But don't get me wrong. Listen. But don't get me wrong. Women, there's nothing wrong with being strong and stable. I'm going to help you out. There's nothing wrong with being strong and stable. Remember, you have that power under control. Jesus, my God. Oh, my God. Watch this. I'm talking about being hard, insensitive, non-emotional. Okay, hold on. Watch this. I'm not talking about having your emotion. Listen, I need y'all to hear this. I'm also not talking about, having your emotions under control. See, that's where the mature woman, that's where that Proverbs 31 woman, that's that woman right there. That she, because of her design, she still has her emotions under control. I got you, teacher. But some people think you're non-emotional. No, that's not in your design. It can't be, because that's not how God designed you. What you see is that you keep yours under control. I got you. I'm going to pray. That's why I don't want y'all to jump to it too far. Let me finish. Okay? Because we quick to be like, that's you. I know that. And what I'm trying to say is you. All right. You need to have those emotions. That's correct. That's true. That's part of your design. Watch this. This is going to help. Oh, this deliverance is going to come free right now. It's going to come forth right now. A woman, men, was designed to respond. And a man was designed to absorb. Oh, y'all ain't ready. A woman is designed to respond, men. And you are designed to absorb. I told somebody a long time ago, I said, men are the diffuser. So when things are about to blow up, what did you see that man jump on that bomb? Yeah. Now he absorbs the impact of the family. He's designed to absorb. He's designed to absorb the impact. See, I told you, we don't know how we're supposed to function in a relationship. No, we don't. Because we have allowed, non-spiritual things to mold my character. Your job, man, her job is to respond to you. No, we don't. You know why? Because men, you want her to act and respond just like you. And she can't.
Oh, wow.
It's not in the design. I listen to people all the time. The men will say, you don't feel what I feel. She ain't designed to feel what you feel. And a man, listen, let me tell you something right here too. And a man that's so emotional, he don't need a wife. You know what he needs? He needs to grow. He don't need a wife until he is grown. He don't need it. I'm going to stick to my word. Y'all tearing up the place. DJ, you with me, DJ? DJ, you with me back there? All right. I want to know, am I helping y'all with y'all relationships? All right. Hell, you're going to be straight when she comes. Hell going to be a package. He's going to be ready. I'm with you. Hey, I'm with you, minister. I listen to my pastor. This will end all discussions and arguments with men. You want her to act and respond like you, and she can't. So stop asking her. All right, I'm almost. Y'all gonna let me finish this? All right. Stop right in the middle. Okay. All right. All right. I need y'all to get that. Before you go anywhere else, I got little stars right here. Women were designed to respond, and men were designed to absorb. See how you just have such a beautiful relationship in a marriage if you would apply, make these applicable to your situation. Some people just need to hear this. You're my spouse, but you know what? I need you to stop, and you need to listen to this right now. Then you can go on about your business, but you need to hear this. If you really love me, you'll hear what I'm saying. It ain't got to be, it's Pastor Rod. No, it's my heart for you. I got you. I hear you. It's what's needed. You don't know how I function. I'm learning how you function, and you don't know how I function. It's an imbalance. It's an abomination, the Bible said. An uneven scale is an abomination. So, men, this should help deliver some of you today. You want her to act and respond, listen, just like you. And she simply cannot. Now, she can surrender. Still going to make it wrong. Still. Mm-hmm. And I simply want her to function in her design. That's right. That's right. That's it. Amen. Here we go. Watch this. Can I finish? Y'all want me to finish? This is just all right. Go ahead. It's plenty of room. You social distancing and all that and there. It's good. All right. Glory to God. All right. So love for a woman means this. I'm going to help you too. Don't get offended again. All right. Yes, you will when I tell you this word. All right. Okay. Woo! Okay. Hold on. Let me put this up here. It said, Pastor Fuel, so y'all won't forget. I'm passed up here right now, but I'm about to sing. All right. Love for a woman means this, friendly. Attention. Hey, Courtney. Hey, Courtney. Hey. Oh, hey. Hey, Eve. Hey, Eve. Oh, Jesus. It's wild in here. It's wild. It's wild. Woo! Oh, I got to give clarity. I'm talking about the women now. Oh, my God. Oh. 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 All right. Ephraim, you with me? You with me? All right. Okay. All right. Okay. All right. Okay. All right. I don't know. I don't know. Maybe they ain't got none. I don't know. I don't know. Maybe they gave it to the woman. Maybe. See that? All right. See that? I got you. That's all. Woo. Okay. Y'all said I can finish, so I'm almost finished. All right. All right. I'll close the book up now. Okay. Okay, teacher. Here we go. Number one. So love for a woman means this. Number one, attention. All the men say attention. I say all the men say attention. Here's another way of saying attention. Here's another way of saying attention. Maximum care. Not medium, but maximum. I take care. Maximum care of my wife. I'm functioning in full design when it comes to my wife. I'm above the top in my maximum tension and care. That's my card. That's my card. Maxima. Woo! Oh my God. The people streaming don't know what is going on in here. All right. All right. Okay. Here we go. I thank God. I thank the Lord. I'm thanking God that he's given me something for us today. I thank him. He gets all the adoration. He gets in the midst of all this. He gets all the everything. He gets all the praise, all the glory, because he loves you. And I'm just willing to tell you the truth. Amen. All right. Watch this, men. A woman will stretch you until she see the highest quality in you possible. Jesus. All right. You cash at me. You can cash at me too. It's working now. Amen. Amen. Watch this. Now listen closely. Listen, you got your shout out. Now listen closely to what I said. A woman, I ain't say can't, a woman will stretch you until, listen, she sees the highest quality in you possible. That's your helper. That's your helper. See, no, we don't want that. She's trying to help you, and you don't want it. No, we don't. Soon, you have to learn, men, you have to learn to be able, listen, to receive her as the helper. You have to be able to receive as that. Now put your ego aside. Now that is your pride and your ego now. See, the problem is that a lot of you have stopped the progress and the growth necessary for the both of you. Because you refuse to see her as her design, as a helper. You ain't even got to get a headache about this. You ain't even got to get frustrated like this. You should be glad that she's operating in her design. For you. All right, here we go. Watch this. Attention for a woman is almost like purpose for you. Oh, my God. Woo! Okay. All right. Y'all, I live this. And then right, teacher, I live this. And people around me know I live this. Attention for a woman is almost like purpose for a man. Wow. I want to do this. Can I, amen, and you receive it as such. I want to define this word attention that has fallen on the wrong soils in the hearts of people. Watch this. Attention simply means this: care. It simply means care. In the Hebrew, the Aramaic, listen, it simply means care. Men,
yes, sir.
We must be caring. And I told you, it also, it's a lot of different dimensions of caring. Caring is seeing a need, you know, for a person tomorrow, and you take care of it today. Amen. Men, we must be caring. It means this right here, to be sensitive. To her needs. Yeah. Oh my God. Yeah. And sometimes you got to put your wallet aside for that. Uh-huh. If that's where we are. Yep. But it's not always that. Right. You must be sensitive to her needs. Yeah. Yeah. So I repent to my wife, because there's sometimes I haven't been. But God is teaching me in certain areas. It's like, that's not I'm there. I'm on my way there. I love it. There's always room for Jello. All right, here we go. It's always room. That's the old saying. Y'all remember that, right? Okay. All right. It's always for improvement. Amen. Listen to that. Men. It means, attention means to be sensitive to her needs. See, but you're missing the point about her emotions. Sensitive to her needs. See, say it like that. Sensitive to her needs. You got to hear it. You got to feel it. Because if you do hear it and you do feel it, you'll move aside you. That's the only reason you can't, because you are still in the way. Remember, we won. Echad. It means be sensitive to her needs. It means to be concerned. Here's the big one. Guess what it means, teacher? It also means, attention means time. I know I've come short on some time from that, but I'm going to make it up. So he can redeem my time. Ah, glory to God. And I'm trying to squeeze all this in, and we have a ministry. I still got to keep the romance going. Right. That means I can't let myself go. And she can't let herself go. Don't test me on that ground. I don't want to be tested on that one. Just keep it together. All right. All right. Y'all listen to this. Attention means be sensitive to her needs. It means to be concerned about her needs. It means time. Men, say time.
Time.
Mm-hmm. This is very important to how God designed her. You hear me now? This is how important it is how God designed her. She needs time. She needs care. This is how God designed her. And he placed that with you. So you can provide that. Okay, I'm going to get to a good part. It means to her, watch this, affection. It means affection to her. Oh, my goodness. Hey, men. This is called, and what happens, this is what a lot of us men, and I want you to fill in this. This is what is required. This is called emotional bonding. So a lot of our marriages are lacking in emotional bonding with her design. y'all didn't. No, y'all didn't. They said at the same time.
You helping me right there.
I'm trying. This is what's happening. And y'all listening? Y'all listening back there? Y'all listening? I want to make sure Effie listening. She listening. Okay. Effie, text any of you listening. All right. That's my girl. Listen to this. It means affection. This is an emotional bonding. Watch this. Most men see it as being needy. And guess what? You are actually correct. You are absolutely right. But see, you have not emotionally bound with her. So like when that baby is freshly and he or she is on the breast, he's emotionally bonding with the mother.
Wow.
Woo! That went right over some folks' head. But here we go. All right. Amen. Good to know. Good to know. And you, my daughter. Amen. Always been here for you. Amen. Glory to God. Oh, listen to this. And this is a missing element in most of our marriages. You call it business, and you ain't got time for that. And a woman will tell the man exactly what she needs. You ain't got to guess. You ain't got to guess. But the problem is you can't hear her. You know why you can't hear? Because you're not emotionally bound with her. You're not emotionally bound with her. You're not. All right. She's needy. Absolutely. You're right. Also, with everything, there is sometime abuse. I got to bring the balance. I'm going to bring the balance. Because sometime could be a certain time throughout the 30 days. Of your existence. That there's times that things can be taken advantage of. Listen, even on both parts. Let's just bring the balance. Emotional bonding is not sex. It's not. Just letting you know. Y'all know it's a bunch of manipulating on both sides. Yeah, you do. You don't want him to go nowhere, but he can't come to you. There's a bunch of manipulating going on. If you want to be a priest, go to seminary. And if you want to get into a relationship, then open your heart. And allow that emotional dimension to find, watch this, expression in every relationship. See, my bonding with you is going to help me emotionally with every relationship that I have. Amen. Should be looking for a woman that will compliment him. Bring him into completion. That's how a man looks for a wife. Love is very important. Love is very important when the concept of love is not defined by the kingdom perspective. If not, there's going to be chaos and anarchy. in your home, within you. Women and men. All right. Before you consider entering into a relationship. Just for some of y'all, not all y'all right now. As believers. See, I'm entering into a relationship as a believer. That's why you can be careful when you go out to the world. Okay. Minister, I know we ain't read a scripture, but I got to get you up there on the thing. Got a scripture for you right quick. We almost done, teacher. Absolutely almost. I promise you. Oh, gee, I'm going to get it. I'm going to get it. Yes, ma'am.
This is marriage.
All right. Into relationships, I told you. As believers, there are qualities that should be in you before you go get married. Okay. There should be certain qualities in you before you get married. Go to Ephesians 5:11, Amplified. Mm-hmm. Come on.
Ready? This is Ephesians chapter 5 at verse 11. The scripture reads, "Take no part in and have no fellowship with the fruitless deeds and enterprises of darkness, but instead let your lives be so in contrast as to expose and reprove and convict them."
Mm. Now, if you were approaching a relationship for marriage, this is how you should qualify that person. First, they have no fruitful, listen, what? Association with darkness. Meaning you can't have no darkness in you before you go and seek somebody else. They can't have darkness. I'm talking about for the believer. That's why a lot of times women struggle with men. I ain't saying it can't happen, but I'm just telling you. All right. This person should be genuinely born again. You ain't got no problem. This makes things so much easier in the relationship because you married a believer. That scripture right there is what qualifies you to enter into a relationship. Okay? You must be born again. Women, don't just choose any kind of head to submit under.
Oh my God.
I'm almost finished. Don't just choose any kind of head to submit under. I think I'm losing you. Hold on. What does it mean to be born again? It means this, teacher, to submit. This is the type of person that you want to marry. That's born again. It means to submit to the governing authority of the Word of God. You ain't gonna have, you ain't gonna be no problems then. All right. That man has to be submitted to the governing authority of the Word of God and to Christ. A man that does not submit to the Word of God can kill everything around you. You know why? Because there's nothing, listen, there's nothing to give him boundaries. There is nothing to determine the terms of his relationship with you. My God. There is nothing to convict him. So women, don't choose the way, because you'll choose the way to hell. This relationship has just been pure hell. Don't choose it, because you're gonna have to fight, and it's gonna be hard. Remember, you're fragile and should be handled with extreme care.